I want to change the color of the sky, and I'm using Affinity Designer. Now, probably a photo is probably going to be better, but Designer can also do it. So what you need to do, got the image there selected, and simply just go to Layer, and down to New Adjustment, and down to HSL. You probably could use some of the other ones as well, but I'm just going to go with HSL. And you can see what happens. You've got this range here, and I'm just going to select the first one here. What that does, it changes everything. So if I just change it, you can see everything changes, and you get some slight pick. I don't really want that. So I'm just going to set that back to zero, because I want to just change the color of the sky. So how to do that? We'll just click there, the blue, any of the blues, doesn't particularly matter. But then you've got the option of picker. Now that's fairly consistent, that blue, so picker, and then just go over the image. And you can see you've got a cursor change there, and you can just click there, and it's very subtle change, but it's still, this is the range that will be modified. You've got the outer range. So if you change that now, as I do that, you can see what happens. You've got the, obviously that goes green. You can see that outer bit changes. Obviously the inner bit, that's the source, that doesn't change. But maybe I decide, you know what, I want pink. Very, very unusual color for a color, for the sky, but I'm gonna go with pink. And you can see as I do that, actually what also happens, unfortunately, this changes, which is not great. It's very subtle, but it's still just slightly annoying. So now I can modify this, of course. I can change the range if I want to. You can just drag that out, maybe make it bring more and more of the image in. And you can see as you do that, makes it worse. Obviously, what I want is very narrow band there of the color. And that's what I want there. However, let's just close that now, because the next thing to do is just to bring in a mask. Now that would be easy in Photo. You could just do it fairly quickly. However, you've only got vector tools, which is not very handy, because if you use one of the vector tools, all it does is put a vector layer. However, you've got personas. So you can go up here to persona and you can click there, just that one, pixel persona. And then you can go down to the paintbrush tool, set it to black, and then just apply it. Now, obviously I don't want to change the color there. I want to change the color here. So I'm just going to just apply it very quickly, you know, just to there. And you can see as I do that, it does change slightly back to what I wanted. So it's just back to the previous color. Now I'm not going to change anything else. That all looks to me, it's probably subtle, but it's very, you could of course go around the whole lot if you wanted to, but it doesn't look like anything's changed. Obviously that stone is not changed because there's no blue in it. So now I've got that, what I can now do, I can go back to the standard Affinity Designer one. And you can see now you've got the nice color. And if you see, of course, an error there, maybe you think, oh, that's could change that as well. You can always go back and tweak it again. But you can see then that design. Now, for some weird reason, I've got a dot in that image. I can't see where that is, but it does seem to show that dot. However, so there's the color of the sky changed. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.